got on personal speaking. Hello everyone! Thank you so much for the dancing again, that was great. First time. Now we have another first time. It's the first time we're going to have a man called Vincent Sanders come to the stage. Fingers crossing I'm pronouncing that correctly. I always forget to check.
Yeah, correct.
Yes!
Yeah.
You think that would be an easy one, but you never know. Please welcome to stage, for the very first time, Vincent Sanders.
Just about the name, Moon Club. I love the moon. Don't you love the moon as well?
Yeah.
But I'm happy that we're just in the Moon Club, because when we would be on the moon, everything would go in slow motion. Luckily we're just here, otherwise it will be a very, very long night. Yeah. But on the moon, strange things happen. So, tonight, if you meet any aliens, robots, it's all fine, you know? We're in the Moon Club, so this is the club for everyone, right?
Yeah.
Good. So, but I also want to be very honest with you all tonight. Very often I just feel very afraid, you know? Just when I walk down the street, I'm just afraid that an alien will abduct me, or that something will happen, something strange, or a robot suddenly, you know, attacks me like... and they follow me around, and then I see more and more people are afraid, and I wonder how is it possible that we're all so afraid. You see, I know a lady, and she signed up for an anxiety training, and I heard that it was full, the whole training was full, but then on the day itself nobody turned up because they're all too afraid to go to the training. And I was like, oh wow, this is a really serious problem starting to happen in our society. So how can we solve this problem? Like, I was walking through the streets of Newton Abbot. I'm living in Newton Abbot, you know?
Are you from Newton Abbot?
Well, I'm from... I'm from the moon, I'm sorry. But I was born in Holland and now I live in Newton Abbot because it's a logical step. Amsterdam, New York, Newton Abbot.
It's the smoke
as well. It's like a city of dreams, a city of hope, a city of peace. But anyway, I was walking down the streets of Newton Abbot and suddenly I saw a charity worker there. Oh, I love charity workers. They're doing so much good work. But then I had this small fear inside, becoming like, a charity worker. But there's no way past him. I have to get past him. You know? And I love charity, but there was just this feeling of, not now. I love to be, do things for charity, but not now. No, not now. I'm in a hurry now. So, and I thought, well, let's just pretend that I don't see him. And I'll just look at the sky. Look at the floor. And he says, hey, you're right, with a smile. And I was like, and that's what most people do when they're afraid. They ignore it. They're just like, what a beautiful day. And I looked behind me and I saw that all people were, they're all diving away for this charity work. Like, no, leave me alone. I just want to do my thing, you know. And everyone is afraid of this guy who's just wanting to do some good for charity.
Yeah.
And then I realized, like, wow, what's happening with us? Why is there so much fear? And I started investigating human beings, you know, because I'm from the moon, so I'm really, I love to investigate human beings. And I saw there's something happening. There is a little creature that everyone, well, nearly everyone has one. And it lives inside your pocket or inside your purse. Oh, I see people looking, what? Serious? Do I have a creature right now with me? Yes. Some people call it iPhone, and others call it an Android. But from my point of view, it's a robot. You know, it was made to call your friends, but now it has changed into a robot that can do everything. Yeah. And I've got got it in my pocket as well. And usually, I look around about 108 times per day. Nothing happened. Still nothing happened. Nothing happened. The news, 50 people have been shot in their face. I'm about to get a nuclear rocket on my head any moment. No, no, there's a virus coming. And refugees as well. See, this robot is making me afraid, and it's like it's alive, you know? It's like a being in my pocket is living there, saying, I know everything about you. I know your passwords. I know the websites that you are surfing on secretly. I know your history and I know your future. But I'm here to help you. But your life is a misery. Look, on Instagram and Facebook, everyone else is much better than you. But I'm here to help you and make your life much nicer and better. Yes, I love you. Don't you love me? Oh, yes, I love you, phone. I'm so happy that you're here. Thank you. By the way, there is a virus coming. You might die tomorrow. Oh, really? No. Oh, I love you anyway. You know, I'm so happy. Swiping as well. Thank you. Oh, I accidentally liked someone's picture. But anyway, I'm just seeing that something is happening. These telephones are infiltrating our, you know, our lives with fear. Of course, there are good things as well, but this is just when I see that these robots slowly taking over our lives. Like when I walk into a restaurant in Newton Abbott, there are actually quite some restaurants there. I go in, for example, to the Thai restaurant. Well, yes, I don't know if that's a restaurant, but I walk in and I see all these people having a great time, full of energy, but they're not talking to each other. They're all looking at their own robots, like, yeah, look at my robot. This was yesterday, and somebody else says, oh, that's nice, well, look at my robot. So they're all just looking, showing the robots to each other, like, look at this, look at this. And they're all obsessed with it. And me too, when I'm there, when I'm in a restaurant, there's always a point that suddenly I notice myself just like looking at my phone and just going like, oh. And I look to the table and I just see everyone on his phone. And then I'm quite, is this why we go to a restaurant to all be on our, look at our robot, like, ha. You know, you take him to the toilet as well, you take him to your bed, and me too, when I wake up, first thing, there was a moment, a time in my life, first thing when I woke up, where's my robot? I started to panic, I couldn't find it, where is it? Oh, here it is, it was still in my pocket, I fell asleep with my robot, and there you are, yeah. And then he just says, it's going to be a horrible day today. Look at the news. Our life is a hell. Our life is full of misery. But I'm here to help you. Thank you, robot. But anyway, and then, you know, if it was just the telephone, you know, that will be alright. But I start to see that the robots are slowly infiltrating us even more. Like, I have a friend, and he says he has been abducted by aliens and robots. Yeah. That's interesting, because he says they went into his bedroom and then they cut open his balls and they put a chip in his balls. And now they're following him around, seeing what he's doing. They're investigating him. So there are alien species investigating a man from Totnes, from Devon. You know? I feel so sad for these aliens. I mean, what will they find investigating a man in Totnes, you know? Yeah. And probably lots of music, lots of fun and drinks. Oh, yeah, sorry, I've been doing it. Yeah, you're right. Totnes is different. Yeah. No, I've just been. Oh, yes, oh, indeed. So that man is probably. In the daytime, he goes to his allotment.
And then, there they do it.
On the allotment. Yeah. Well, anyway, when I heard that story, I was just so concerned. And I went home, you know, and I was like, what's happening? Are they coming to my bedroom now? And I just saw my hull, and I'm missing. There's no coat rack in my hull, you know? When nobody can put up his jacket, so everyone just dumps it on the floor. And suddenly I just felt tired of that. And I was like, well, I'm gonna go online, and I'm gonna order a coat rack right now. So here I was, behind my computer, going online, and I found one, and I wanted to order it. So I had to put in my email address and sign up, and then suddenly there was a box. Say, confirm you are not a robot. What? Do I have to confirm my computer is a robot asking me to confirm I am not a robot? What's happening? What are these robots doing to me? And I said, well, of course I'm not a robot. So I tick the box. Yes. And then suddenly, my computer said to me, prove you are not a robot. What? I just tick the box and now I have to prove it? Okay, I will prove that I'm not a robot. So I stood up in my living room and I said, well, do you think a robot can do this? See, robots can't do that. Wanna see it again? See? I've never seen a robot doing that. Check this out, computer. And suddenly someone was knocking on my window. So I looked. It was the postman looking through the window. But I didn't know what it was, and I was still showing the computer that I was not a robot. And everything went in slow motion. And I looked at the postman like. And the postman was looking at me through the window with a letter. And I was there like, well, I'm proving I'm not a robot, don't you understand? And then he ran off as fast as he could. And then I realized, what am I doing in my living room? He must think that I'm having some kind of digital orgy or something, or that I'm having webcam, you know, sex with someone, and I'm in my living room and he caught me in action.
Where are you?
Well, you're a robot. I was, you know, and I was so upset. And then I watched better, and there were just a few letters that I had to fill in. That was all. I had to prove I was not a robot by filling in, you know, HGL7213HBC.
Easy.
Yeah. But the letters were like waves, going like this. Waves, so, you know, when a robot sees waves, he just gets an error, like, that's not nice. But, you know, before I carry on, I just want to make sure that there are no robots tonight before a robot fundamentalist will shoot me after the show. So can you just check to look at your neighbor to the left and the right and just gently smile. Just give a little smile to your neighbor. And okay, and on both sides there, and just make sure, any robots tonight?
No robots.
Ah, I'm so happy, so I'm safe. So, because you know how to recognize a robot? They have quite a stiff upper lip and a big jaw. And they have no sense of humor, so when you make a joke, they try to laugh, so they're just like, ha ha ha. When a robot gets an error, they just don't stop. It just goes on forever, like, ha ha ha. And they walk through the streets of Newton Abbott. I've seen them. It's true. They're coming for us. But don't worry, we can do something. So that's why I'm here tonight. To change our destiny. To change the world. We can make it. Can't we? We are together. Yeah! Applause for yourself. The human beings. Yeah, that's great. You know? Because my message is, can we just let go the attachment of telephones and robots? And of course we can use it. It's great. I love my phone. I love you. But I just want to have a more balanced relationship with my telephone and with the robots. Because before, we know they take over our lives. And originally they are here to help us, to make our lives better. But you see, I was typing an email to my boss for work. And I have my robot has something called autocorrect. So he corrects me when I'm wrong. And I was proudly writing this email. Ah, I'm meeting this new client. And then my robot, my phone, made, I am a binge-eating ninja. And I was like, what?
What are you doing?
What is a binge-eating ninja? Is it like a sumo wrestler in a cat suit going to an Indian restaurant on the buffet night, like, secretly binge-eating, like I can do myself as well? Maybe that robot is right. Maybe he has been following me around. He knows more than I think. But anyway, see, we've lost it a little bit, and I just want to bring back some balance. Like, we all came from water. So how did we went from water? See, we're fluidic, aren't we? Some people are sitting like, it's okay, you know, you can just loosen up a little bit. So how did we get from this to thank you, It's strange. So let's go back to the way of the water and fluidity and let go the attachment to technology. And I really feel that everyone here has done that already. So thank you for listening to my process. And I just want to say a big thank you and hope to see you again.
Your heart says.
Thank you, Vincent Sanders. As usual, we'll be back. You know we will be. We are returning with a gentleman called Gino. So before he's famous, just get your nose on it, just the check. Because after this, Jesus, we're about to get near him.